The Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization process given a basis v1 v2 etc vk of the subspace W of R power n. The following vector forms the orthogonal basis of the subspace. So we will take v1 to be equal to u1. That means u1 is equal to v1. Then we take u2, which is equal to v2 minus the projection of v2 on u1. So early in the last session we discussed all these things, that this vector v2 minus of orthogonal projection of v2, which is equal to u2, is perpendicular to u1. So therefore the vector u2 is perpendicular to u1, means orthogonal to u1. Similarly we find u3, which is equal to the vector v3 minus the projection of v3 on u1 and minus the projection of v3 on u2. So this vector is orthogonal to, u3 is orthogonal to this vector u2. If we continue the same procedure, we move to the vector uk, which is equal to vk minus inner product of uk comma u1 divided by u1 comma u1 into u1 minus etc inner product of vk minus inner product of vk comma uk minus 1 divided by uk minus 1 uk minus 1 uk. The collection of vectors u1 divided by norm u1, u2 divided by norm u2, etc uk divided by norm uk is an orthonormal basis of the subspace W. We will take a simple example to see how we can apply the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization process to find the orthogonal as well as orthonormal vectors. The question is, apply Gram-Schmidt process to 001, 011 and 111 and write the result in the form of A is equal to Q into R. Now, as usual, we take U1 equal to V1. So here V1 is 0, 0, 1, so this is the vector 001, and v2 is 011, and we assume that v3 is 111. So these are the three vectors. Now we take u2 is equal to v2 minus inner product of v2 with u1 divided by inner product of u1 with u1 into u1. This is the projection of the vector v2 on u1, which is perpendicular to u2. So that is equal to, so substitute v2 here, minus, if you find inner product of v2 into u1, so u1 is here, so 001, v2 is here, 001, so the inner product is 0 into 0 plus 0 into 1 plus 1 into 1, that is 1, divided by inner product of u1, that means sum of the squares of the component, 0 square plus 0 square plus 1 square, that is also 1, so 1 divided by 1 will be 1, into u1. So what is u1? 001. So therefore we find in place of v2 it is 011 minus, here this value is 1, into u1. What is u1? u1 is 001. Now if you use the matrix addition or subtraction, you can find 0 minus 0 0, 1 minus 0 1, 1 minus 1 0. So u2 is equal to the vector 010. Similarly we can find u3 using this formula, that is equal to 111. What is v3 is 111 minus inner product of v3 into u1. If you find inner product of v3 into u1, that is you will find 1. Similarly inner product of u1 into u1, you will find 1 into u1. So u1 is 001 minus, here also you will find this coefficient equal to 1 if you calculate the inner product, into u2. So the u2 is 010. Now 1 minus 0 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 0 minus 1 0, 1 minus 1 minus 0 is 0. So 100 is the vector u3. So these are the orthogonal vector. If you want to find the orthonormal vector, we have to divide those vector by their norm, that means by their length. We know that their length is their length is 1, therefore they itself, these vectors itself is orthonormal vectors. Now we find it the orthonormal vectors, but we have to write the matrix A as product of Q into R. Here Q is the matrix whose columns are these vectors. Q is the matrix whose columns are the orthonormal vectors. So Q is equal to 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 0. Now to find R, because A equal to Q R means R must be equal to Q transpose into A. So now R is equal to Q transpose into A. What is Q transpose? You will find the same matrix here, therefore, which is equal into A. So A is this matrix. So what actually is this transformation do is it will rotate it. So it will rotate this matrix. You can check that if you do the multiplication, you will find this matrix 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 0 1, just rotation of this. Now there, this is our R, therefore Q, this is Q, so this is Q, Q into A, Q into R, this is R, is equal to, this is A, the matrix A. You can check this. So Q into R is equal to A, R, A is equal to Q R. Let us move to the next problem. The next problem is, once again, the process is Gram-Smith orthogonalization process to find the orthonormal vectors from these vectors. So first vector is 2, 2, 1, that is V1, 1, 3, 1, that is V2, and 1, 2, 2 is our V3. Now, as usual, U1 is equal to V1. So what is V1? 2, 2, 1. Now, what is U2? U2 is equal to V2 minus inner product of V2 comma U1 divided by U1 comma U1 into U1. So how to find inner product of V2 comma U1? So we have V2 here, this is the vector V2, this is vector U1. So inner product means multiply the components and add it. 2 into 1 plus 2 into 3 plus 1 into 1. So 2 plus 6, 8 plus 1, 9. So that is 9. Similarly, inner product of U1, U1 means sum of the squares of this, 2 square, 2 square, 1, 1 square. So 4 plus 4 plus 1, 9. 9 by 9 is 1 once again. Therefore, we have V2 is 1, 3, 1 minus this is 1 and U1. U1 is 2, 2, 1. So therefore, the vector is 1 minus 2 minus 1. 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So this is the vector U2. Now, similarly, we can find the vector U3. The vector U3 is equal to V3 minus, this is the formula here to find the vector U3, V3 minus inner product of V3 comma U1 into U1 divided by inner product of U1, U1 minus inner product of V3 comma U2, inner product of U2 comma U2, U2. So now if you find the inner product of the numerator here, you will find 8, denominator is 9. So 8 by 9, so U1 is 2, 2, 1. Similarly minus, if you find the inner product of the numerator, you will find 1, denominator will be 2. So 1 by 2, what is U2? U2 is the vector minus 1, 0, 1. Now if you simplify this, you will find the vector minus 5 by 18, minus 5 by 18 and 10 by 9. Therefore, we have orthogonal vectors. Which are the orthogonal vectors? U1, U2, that is equal to minus 1, 1, 0, 2, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 0, U3 is minus 5 by 18, minus 5 by 18, 10 by 9 are orthogonal vectors. Now we have to normalize it. So if you normalize, normalize means what? Divide those vector by their length. So what is their length? Yes. Length of un, length of U1, if you calculate, that is norm of U1, you will find 3. So therefore U1 divided by 3 is 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 1 by 3. Similarly, if you calculate the norm of U2, the norm of U2 will be square root of 2. Therefore U2 by norm U2 will be minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0 by root 2 is 0. Similarly, if you calculate norm of U3, norm of U3, you will find 15 root 2 divided by 18. Therefore U3 divided by norm U3 is equal to, so minus 5 by 18 divided by 15 root 2 by 18. If you calculate, 18, 18 cancels. So 1 by 5, 3s are 15, so minus 1 by 3 root 2. Similarly, you can find this minus 1 by 3 root 2. Similarly, 10 by 9 divided by 15 root 2 by 18. If you do the calculation, you will find 4 divided by 3 root 2. Yes, now to express the vector A in QR form, we have to write the matrix Q. whose columns are those orthonormal vectors. So the orthonormal vectors we obtained are 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, minus 1 divided by 3 root 2, minus 3, minus 1 divided by 3 root 2, 4 divided by 3 root 2. Now, how to calculate R? R is equal to Q transpose into A. Because since Q is orthonormal vector, its inverse is transpose is itself is its inverse. So this is equal to what? What is Q transpose? 2 by 3 this vector. If you take the transpose of this matrix, you will find this. And A is the matrix whose columns are the given vectors 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 1, 1, 2, 1. Now, a simple matrix multiplication will give you a upper triangular matrix. Remember that this product is always an upper triangular matrix. So therefore, you will find 3, 3, 8 by 3, 0 root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 5 divided by 3 root 2. Next, this is R and A is equal to Q into R. So this is your Q matrix whose columns are orthonormal vectors, and this is the R. If you multiply these two, you will get the matrix A.